Wow, just wow. I mean, this is an unusually bad casting decision for Disney. In fact, I was going to make a joke that this is like Warner Brothers cast the role. But let's be fair, Warner Brothers just did something really interesting with Robert Pattinson as their new Batman. So Disney, you're out here on your own. And your movie might be out there on its own now, too. Now, some of you might be, I'm sure, typing right now in defense of McCarthy, well, what about Will Smith, Grace? Everybody thought that was a bad idea right up until the film's release, and it turned out great. And to all of you typing, Grace, it's still a bad idea, well, audiences worldwide have spoken, and just as Will Smith announced this morning, Aladdin has become his most successful film of all time, surpassing Independence Day. So you might not personally like Aladdin, but Disney would be very happy with similar results for their upcoming live-action Little Mermaid. But anyway, when Will Smith was cast as the genie, he at least was coming off of Suicide Squad, which also had its detractors, but did very well at the box office. And even Focus was kind of Will Smith working his way back. But McCarthy, she might have just gotten another Oscar nomination, and the kitchen does look very good, but cheap. You know, McCarthy, I can't see her in the middle of a movie that doesn't look like maybe it shouldn't be on a big screen. Oh, okay, well, I'm getting ahead of myself. We're talking about McCarthy's recent past. And her career is at a spectacular low point right now. I think she still has not recovered from Ghostbusters. And I can't believe that Disney would take her on to a project that should be a slam dunk. And it's weird to me, you know, Lin-Manuel Miranda is doing the music for this new music with Alan Menken, right? Lin-Manuel Miranda is a huge Little Mermaid fan. He named his son Sebastian. So considering that his Hamilton was partially made famous for its inventive casting, that he and Disney would pick such an obvious, boring choice for live-action Ursula, again, it's truly a shocking development. I mean, it's not a woman of color. For some reason, a number of people, as we found out recently on social media, mistakenly believe that Ursula was voiced by an actress of color originally. She was not, but, you know, many people still associate the role, you know, potentially in that way. And Queen Latifah, for instance, you know, has done a very famous photo shoot as the character. So some people wanted her, Ursula, to be played by an actress of color. Also a drag queen. There were a number of people pushing for that because the character was based on Divine from Hairspray. Very famous, well, at the time, you know, not like today, obviously, with RuPaul. I heard a rumor that RuPaul, I couldn't verify it, but that RuPaul had auditioned for Sebastian, which is amazing casting, quite frankly. But anyway, there is some precedent for casting a drag queen as Ursula. And then also, Lady Gaga. A number of us wanted Lady Gaga because she has such a strong LGBT fan base that you could kind of maybe appease the people who are in the drag queen camp while still maybe not pushing away, you know, middle America moviegoers who you quite frankly need to get your movie to a billion. So everybody was fighting it out on social media as to the direction that Ursula could go. She even trended a couple of times, right? But this is like, wow, Disney, just like, let's just make everyone angry. Like, let's unite them in how they all hate the choice that we made, right? And as far as, you know, picking a difficult, you know, changing a character, let's say, right? I think it can be done with the right actor. I mean, when I heard RuPaul as Sebastian, it just clicked and you're like, that's perfect. And I think everyone, you know, even the most middle Americanist person would think that RuPaul would make a wonderful, absolutely wonderful Sebastian. We'll get to that in a moment, that maybe this is queuing up a bold choice down the line. We can only hope. But yeah, I mean, look at Will Smith. He did, you know, they successfully race-bended Genie. And I think maybe Disney might feel it would be difficult to race-bend two such big, iconic characters back-to-back. But again, I think, you know, you want the right actor. As soon as you say it, you know it. And when you say Melissa McCarthy is Ursula, all I think most of us know is that she's not Ursula, right? And also, what was wrong with Gaga? She was such a great idea. I mean, it would have changed the image of the character, but it would have been so great in so many other ways. It would have been really interesting and unique. I mean, we saw you chasing her down all over the place, Bob, a couple of months ago. What happened? Anyway, the only box that Melissa McCarthy checks is being a plus-sized actress. I'm just so scared in the direction they might take the character because of that. I mean, Ursula is a unique elegant, nuanced villain and female character. And to boil her down to Melissa McCarthy's loud and crass shtick, which has become very lazy recently, it's just not only shocking, but I think the more I think about it, the more it becomes sad and it's an unfortunate decision, right? Considering where they could have gone here. Now, as I said, the only silver lining is that maybe with this safe, obvious choice for Ursula, Disney is getting ready to make a bolder choice somewhere else in the cast. And you know what? It still could work. You might just be so desperate for a better casting decision and a more interesting actor that when they maybe pick someone who you might not have been okay with before, you'll be like, well, at least it's not Melissa McCarthy. Because I think we're obviously talking about Ariel and or Eric. I mean, Zendaya's red hair that she recently sported at a Spider-Man Far From Home press event, an ode, she said, to the original MJ Watson, but it got a lot of us excited about how great she would be as Ariel. I'm very supportive of that casting. And it makes a lot of sense, by the way. Some of you were like, Hans Christian Andersen, why would you re-spin the characters? Well, talk to Disney about it, because back when they started off their animation renaissance, they relocated the story to the Caribbean. And so I think it makes a lot of sense that the royalty above and below the water in the story would be regionally appropriate, especially, again, in today's environment. A lot has changed. And I guess, I don't know, Melissa McCarthy's Ursula swam down from the waters of New England. I guess that's how they're going to decide to explain that away. Now, to be fair, Melissa McCarthy is or can be a very good actress. She does have two Oscar nominations. And I think it's commendable the work that she's done with her fashion line to support other plus-size women wanting to feel good about themselves and look good. So she's got that going for her, right? But considering that director Rob Marshall didn't do anything interesting with Into the Woods, I mean, it was pleasant enough, but I don't think he really pushed the edge of the envelope, right? And he really didn't do anything interesting with Mary Poppins Returns. Talk about lazy. Well, I just don't think he's the guy who can keep McCarthy from succumbing to her worst habits. And they say that 90% of directing, by the way, is casting, and this already seems like really lazy directing for Rob Marshall. And back to pushing the edge of the envelope, I am now concerned that McCarthy's casting could dissuade other top actors who maybe would do something really interesting with this from boarding the film. They might be like, well, maybe I would have done Lin-Manuel Miranda's Little Mermaid before, but I don't want to be in Melissa McCarthy's next movie. I think that's a genuine fear. And, you know, Lin-Manuel Miranda, I don't know how he's going to factor into all of this, being such a big fan of the source material. Well, you know, not Hans Christian Andersen's, but, you know, I'm sure he likes that too, but, you know, particularly Disney's animated version, and being an actor and a little bit of a showboater, let's be honest here, I would imagine he wants to see himself somewhere on screen. I thought, you know, maybe he'd want to be Sebastian in honor of his son, but if you don't cast a black actor in that role, Twitter's just going to kill this movie. It might kill it anyway. I'm sure it's certainly giving it the evil eye as we speak. So I'm curious, what do you think? I mean, many of you are very eager to see the live-action Little Mermaid move forward at Disney, but how do you feel about it now? Careful what you wish for, right? Share those thoughts down below. Be sure to hit that subscribe button. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.